This is John Stewart, Green Lantern of Sector 2814, and you are listening to Geek Talk.
This is Professor Charles Xavier. There are more powerful mutants out there, but they're listening to Geek Talk.
What's up, everybody? It's Brad Hawkins, Ryan Steele from VR Troopers. We are VR, and you're tuned in to Geek Talk.
This is Dr. Egghead. How am I supposed to conquer the world and build the Eggman Empire if they're always listening to Geek Talk? Hedgehog!
This is the Didact. Humanity's imprisonment is a kindness, but not while listening to Geek Talk.
This is Ryu from Wreck-It Ralph, and you're listening to Geek Talk.
Hadouken!
This is Marek Ishtar. Let the Shadow Game begin! You're listening to Geek Talk.
This is Juno Eclipse. I've got a bad feeling about this, but you're listening to Geek Talk.
This is Commodore Don Krieg of One Piece. Don't ever defy me. Listen to Geek Talk. That is an order.
This is Lionel, and you're listening to Geek Talk. Thunder, 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 Thundercats, ho!
Hey, it's James Arnold Taylor, the voice of Obi-Wan Kenobi.
And Master Plo Koon. And I sense the Force is strong with Geek Talk.
Master Plo? Do you talk geek?
Kotoya, Obi-Wan. Kotoya.
Oh, Kotoya indeed. Now if anybody else can figure out what he's talking about, let's listen to Geek Talk.
Welcome to another exciting episode of Geek Talk. We are here today. I'm Tony, your usual host, and the Geek of the Week, of course, as always. And, of course, like last week, and my host for a while, till we decide it isn't anymore, I got Dr. G.
Yay! How are you?
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
I'm doing all right. How about yourself, girl?
I'm doing pretty good. I'm kind of tired because I've been running around chasing after Basebook, and Basebook decides to change everything on you.
I thought you were running around playing that Pokemon Go.
No.
Well, dang it.
I don't know how to play that. I saw someone play it, and I looked at it. I still don't know how to play it. I'm all clueless. I'm like,
Dang it, here everybody's was thinking that you were going out playing that Pokemon Go and catching all those nice Pokemon like Pikachu and Charizard and all that.
Pokemon, I'm going to kill those guys, all of them.
No, we don't want to kill. Oh, we just want to beat them with the Pokeballs.
What?
Yeah, that's what they use, is
beat
Pokeballs.
Them with balls.
Pokeballs.
Oh, whatever.
Well, we could always paint baseballs to look like Pokeballs.
Yeah, throw them hard. I've been watching a lot of baseball lately.
Who has the team you've been watching?
Mariners mainly.
Oh.
I have to go boo. My father-in-law was here, and he likes baseball a lot. Of course, you know, preseason NFL has started, so, you know.
Yeah, I haven't been paying much attention to that, so.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, I've been doing okay. I just got back Saturday. I went to the one-day convention here in Watertown here, and actually it was called Akuakon. Mm-hmm. And they have done it. This is their third year in a row to do it. That was pretty good. I enjoyed doing that. I actually picked up some nice stuff. I actually picked up one of these Star Wars books that has the moving images. Mm. Which, basically, the book, when you open the pages, it moves the images.
Wow.
Like it has Luke and Vader fighting lightsabers. Then it also has Boba Fett flying.
Boba Fett flying?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it's really nice. I picked it up for $5 at one of the booths. So.
Cool beans.
And then I also picked up a couple action figures for the collection. So, it was a good weekend. I enjoyed it. Got to meet a lot of different new people. Mm-hmm. So that was all actually pretty good. I enjoyed it. In fact, in probably going to be doing some business stuff with the place that it was that was putting the convention on.
Good luck.
So, but then
that's awesome.
And then over the weekend, I took and messaged another convention that actually is about the town is about 2.5 hours away from me. It's Fargo, North Dakota, and I messaged, there's an anime convention here toward the end of September, and I took and asked them about a media pass, see about if I could get a media pass for the podcast, for Geek Talk here. And guess what? It happened.
Woohoo!
Geek Talk is being represented at Anime Fargo.
Woo.
We are going to be doing a live convention stuff at Anime Fargo this year. I've never been there, but I'm looking forward to it, and I plan on bringing at least 3 interviews back for celebrity guests.
Good luck.
And then next year, I plan on hitting up probably SuperCon. This year, SuperCon actually had Power Rangers guests.
Oh, Power Rangers. Yay!
And we do cover Power Rangers on Geek Talk, so...
Of course!
Of course. We wouldn't be geeks if we didn't cover that.
We wouldn't.
Have you seen the stuff for the new Power Rangers?
A little bit, but not a whole lot.
Well, I'm kind of interested to see how these new suits and stuff, how this new Rita Repulsa is going to be.
I saw a weird picture of her.
In a green poison ivy type suit?
Yeah, well, no, this is her looking through glass-like thing.
Yeah, she always had, in the TV series, she actually always had a telescope. Type thing that
she's looking through a window. It looked like she was looking through a window.
She might be looking through the looking glass, but hard to say. So we'll have to see what they actually do.
And I thought she had horns on her head.
Well, in the TV series she did. But
well,
they
she didn't have any horns on her head.
Yeah, I don't know. This is going to be interesting to see how they pull it off. It's kind of a new age of Power Ranger movies.
Yeah.
So, I mean, even the suits look really crazy, look different. I mean, they kind of look a little bit more Should I say they tried making them a little more streamlined?
Oh.
I mean, metallic. It's not going to be the same as the original Power Rangers movie.
With all the colors.
It's going to still have the colors, but it's not going to be as bright, I don't think. So, we'll have to wait and see what they do. Hopefully, it can actually turn out pretty good. So, but, yes, within the next year, I should be hopefully getting to a few more conventions around this area.
Mm-hmm.
And getting some more stuff. But it's always, it's going to be fun. I'm looking forward to it. So, but in other means, lately Fox has not been working for me, so I have to kind of play it by ear comes to Fox on some things, like Gotham. But in Gotham, though, the word is if Gotham Season 4 makes it to Season 4, Gotham makes it to Season 4, and right now they're going into Season 3. If they make it into Season 4, they're bringing Jerome, a.k.a. the Joker, back into the actual Joker role. So, the director, let me pull this, actually did has sent it that they're bringing them back. If they do it.
seem to like the results that they got with named Jared.
Leto?
Yeah, in Suicide Squad. He did, I heard he did a good job.
Yeah, I heard Suicide Squad has been good. There's been a lot of rave reviews about it, so it's hard to say. But yes, in the news, this article here, it says Gotham producers John Stevens confirmed in a recent interview that Monaghan would return and that the show has big plans for him moving forward. So, but Stevens also says, do not expect Jerome to just pop up next season. Basically, what they're doing is building him up over time to his return. I mean...
But I thought he was killed. They killed him.
Well, if you haven't caught season two, they've been bringing a lot of key players back. Because in season one, at the end of season one...
Why won't you just die? Why won't you just die?
Fish Mooney...
coming back.
Came back.
Yeah.
They brought her back. Thanks to Doctor Strange.
Yeah.
So, we're looking at if the way they're coming out with things, because Victor Freeze, they saved him. They brought him back to life.
Yeah, they've done a lot of bringing resurrections.
Which is what the Batman saga has been.
Yeah.
In Gotham and stuff, because Victor Freeze got brought back through his cryogenic freezing. I mean. And then at the same time, we're going to see a darker side of Enigma.
Yeah, he turned into the Riddler fully.
Well, not yet. He's still kind of the Riddler, but he's still Edward Enigma.
He's still Edwardy.
Yeah.
He still works for the people?
No, he does not work for the GCPD anymore. He actually got killed for that. Or, not killed, but put in prison for what he did, framing Jim Gordon.
No.
So, and all that. So he Yes, he's in Arkham Asylum, and he's playing...
Everyone is in Arkham Asylum.
Well, that's where a lot of the villains go.
Don't is that what happens?
Yeah, a lot of the villains go to Arkham.
Okay, so here's a question, and it's a Batman question. Well, not really a Batman question, but...
Oh, okay.
Red Hood is one of Batman's sons, right? Or...
Later on.
Yeah.
But in the Gotham series right now, it was a gang of, basically, should I say, criminals that wore a red face mask.
Okay.
And basically, they took and had the Red Hood be a symbol of, should I say, the leadership.
Okay.
Whoever wore the red hood was the leader. But the thing is the criminals ended up whole gang?
Yeah.
Got killed. So, but we are going to be probably seeing a new red hood pop up here in season 2, 3, or 4. If they
but
go
not,
season four.
Not Jason Todd.
Not yet. See, okay. Right now, to go kind of with the movies, I think, and the DC Universe, I don't think they're going to be doing anything with Jason Todd yet. It's kind of like Star Wars.
Because they made a video of Arkham Asylum or something. I haven't played it, but I've seen it. And it's a new DLC, and it has him in there.
Well, the thing is the Gotham TV series is kind of going off a little less of the comic books in a way.
Yeah.
Then it's kind of like the Star Wars movies.
Yeah, and the TV just series. Making up their own stuff.
They're going as coming along as they go. They're trying to give the backstory of how some of these villains actually came about wanting to do what they do. Like Victor Freeze.
Yeah.
They actually showed how his wife, he was trying to save his wife. But the thing is in the movies, like say the original movie,
mm-hmm.
he took and his wife was still alive, and they'd try getting his wife saved. He was still trying to save his wife.
Yeah.
At the same time, trying to get the money for it.
To do a research.
Exactly. For the disease she had. But in this TV series, she completely dies. They finish her off. So, it's going to be interesting how it plays out in the end.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's kind of interesting how it is and what they'll be doing. Because normally, when they finish off the character, that it's done. But in this case, with the way they've been playing Doctor Strange's part,
yeah,
they've been bringing the characters back.
Yeah. In a weird way.
Right.
Not like Frankenstein style.
Well, somewhat, but not exactly.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, because of the fact that they've been, like, say, like Fish Mooney.
Yeah.
She ended up taking and doing, should I say, with Toy Master, or what that, the Toy Maker,
mm-hmm.
he actually took and gave her new life.
Is that what he did?
He basically made a deal with her and took and gave her, because she stabbed out her eye.
But he gave her a blue eye.
Right. He took another eye from someone else and put it in her.
Transplant.
Exactly. And then she made a deal with him and basically took and changed the storyline by having the inmates that, I'm going to call them,
mm-hmm.
take an uprise.
It was more like a test subjects.
Right. Test subjects, basically. But yeah, that's what they were doing. So, but it's going to be interesting to see if they go into season 4.
Mm-hmm.
So, hopefully I think they can do it. But other news, some movie news, is, you know how they're coming, right?
Yep.
Well, we talked about it a little bit last week, how they should go about doing it, but they're doing it wrong. But they are kind of going in Justice League. And Henry Cavill actually tweeted himself a black-colored suit for Justice League. So if you haven't watched Batman vs. Superman, it actually, the way they've said it in this article, basically, you've Superman. I know. I'm pretty sure.
No, I haven't.
You haven't? Well,
I
won't spoil it for you, but there's the ending.
I'm not going to get spoiled. I'll probably never get to see it.
Well, basically, Superman does end up dying at the end. Quote, unquote, dying. But from what...
Dying for the way that they're trying to do... do Gotham.
Then at the end, the dirt on his... that is been thrown on top of him a little bit, because Lois ends up taking and throwing some dirt on him on the coffin. Well, the dirt rises up like a, should I say, electromagnet's been pushing it. So basically signifying the return of Superman or the Man of Steel in Justice League. Well, Henry Cavill, the guy who's plays Superman, actually tweeted on his Twitter him an actual black colored suit, which can signify in that he did don, since with Superman's comics, he does don a black suit after a major event. So
that's in the comics.
Exactly. It is in the comics. So, and because the only other time you see a black suit on a Kryptonian was Zod in Man of Steel. So, the question is, what they bring up on this article is, does this mean Superman is going to take a different role? Or will he be darker than ever?
Was he dark in that in the movie?
Not really. He wasn't really dark in that. So, we'll have to wait and see.
So he's still a good guy in there, and then something happens.
Well, he dies and all that. But then again, he gets struck by kryptonite, too.
Oh. But when getting struck by kryptonite, that was Lex Luthor doing that to him.
Well, Lex Luthor was the one who obtained the kryptonite.
So someone gave him kryptonite.
Well, Lex Luthor gained the kryptonite, but Batman, or Ben Affleck's Batman, took and made a spear.
Oh.
Which Doomsday was formed by the former Zod. Former Kryptonian Zod. General Zod.
So then the next bad guy really be Brainiac.
We don't know yet. It's possible. But they also signified, actually, from what I'm reading, what I've read, is the next one, the next, should I say, movie? In Justice League, from what I've seen and read, is there's the first proof of Darkseid making it his way in. So, which basically...
But Darkseid is just a guy from outer space who's like...
He is Superman's main villain in the most, for the most part, besides Lex Luthor.
Yeah.
So,
but he'd be messing with everybody.
Yes, it's true. He would be messing with everybody, but at the same time, is he's also looking to, for they're going to start off with what is his generals, one of his generals, making a trip in. So, could we end up seeing Darkseid in a future DC movie? I mean, X-Men brought in Apocalypse. A Marvel's brought in Thanos. DC's biggest asset for villain is Darkseid.
Yeah, because... But did they have that in their Superman? They had a lot of... what do they call them? Easter eggs. They had Darkseid Easter egg in that movie.
I believe so. But they also had a possible Brainiac Easter
egg. Yeah, that too. They had Brainiac and they had Darkseid. But I think the Darkseid was very obvious. The Brainiac wasn't.
Right. Brainiac might be after Darkseid.
Yeah.
They may be bringing in Darkseid here within the next few films. Which basically means that it's going to be interesting to see what they do with it.
I am Darkseid.
But I actually had a trivia question that came up when I took and was at the convention this past week. A guy and I were talking, and I took and picked up a Darkseid figure, and we go, basically, who would win in a battle? Darkseid or Darth Vader?
Oh, God. I hate those. It's two different verses.
Yes, but they're the two most powerful villains in their universes.
Well, what makes Darth Vader evil? That's the whole question.
Yes, but
we have not really seen that in Darth Vader.
Yes, but the thing is the question would be, could Darth Vader avoid the Omega Beam?
I don't know. Would there be an Omega Beam Star Wars?
That's Darkseid's main power, is the Omega Beam. And that comes from his eyes and stuff.
Yes. Would there be a beam in Star Wars like that that's not on the Death Star?
I believe so, because of the fact that he gets it, like, it would basically be like a force power. Almost.
No, Omega Beam is something he found, and he shoots it out of his eyeballs as a technology still.
Right, he's got it as part of him, though.
The Force is not a technology. Doesn't even matter if it's tech or not. You still have it, or you don't.
Right. So, but yeah, it would be interesting to see that battle.
You're killing me!
I may have to take this to
adulterating my Vader, thank you. I don't even like the guy.
Well,
Use on Bong. There. That will answer your question.
Yes, I know you would.
That auntie quite a bit.
Yeah, you would go for the Yusan Vong, hands down.
Yeah. It'll be a fight, but, you know, technology is always moving forward. So he has technology.
Right. But, you
have droid disable capability, which Darth Vader does technically have as a Sith Lord.
Right. Well, like I said, that was the question that I proposed somebody, and he said it would just depend on if Vader could avoid the Omega Beam.
Maybe. I think if he would know that there is an Omega Beam, and that if he would not get shot by it, then he could easily, you know, take it and use it for himself.
Right.
But why would he want to do that when he could easily manipulate Darkseid's brain anyway?
Maybe. The thing is Darkseid's also had the Martian Manhunter try to get inside his brain. Control his brain.
Well, they getting in there is one thing. Getting out is a totally different thing. The other thing is that Sith don't just you. If you're talking about the power of the Sith, by in and of itself, you know, they don't just use force powers to convince you.
Right. But how about this? This week's trivia question for the listeners on Channel 1138 and also the ones on YouTube. Okay, this is the trivia question of the week. This is the debate of the week. Who do you think would win between Darkseid and Darth Vader?
That's just like a whole bunch of shots off in the dark, dude.
Hey, I'd like to know what the listeners think. What do you think?
I don't want to know what those listeners think.
It don't matter. Who do you think would win, in Darkseid or Darth Vader? That's the trivia question of the week. It's going to be interesting to see what they say. I look forward to it. So, but yes. And then, so we're going to see a dark suit for Mr.
So. Well, they've been talking. Oh, they've been talking about the bad guy for Aquaman, which is Mantis.
Well, yeah, that's always been the only major bad guy that Aquaman's really ever faced was Mantis.
So they're wondering who could play it. A bunch of people say Keith David should do the voice for sure.
Yeah. Well, it's hard to say.
Mm-hmm.
So, we'll have to wait and see who they cast for
so that. So, everybody's bad guy comes on in Justice League? That's kind of butt-holy.
I don't think everybody's bad guy is going to be coming on. Because you got... Which bad guy would the Flash be facing?
The only bad guy
would be Zoom.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think all the bad guys are going to be coming out. Because they're going to mainly have... The only way that they could do it is if they did it in multiple versions.
Yeah. Well, that's lame.
I mean, because...
You need one big bad guy, but then you don't want to look like a Tolkien. A Loki.
Well,
a Loki.
You're not going to... You're going to try... They're going to try not to... Pull a Marvel is what I think they're going to try not doing.
Yeah, well, they can't help it. They just like us too much.
Well, we'll have to see. But in other news, this week we lost another great actor.
Yep.
2016. Why are you being so mean?
Yep.
In Star Wars,
sucky.
Kenny Baker passed away this week. And for those of us in the geek world, we wish him rest in peace. If you don't know who he was R2-D2 in Star Wars, the original trilogy. So, yes. And I was about to send off to have him sign a picture for me, too. Soon.
That's too bad.
But... Yes, he was, from what I heard, he was really good at conventions and really loved his fans.
Yeah.
So, hopefully his family does well with it, and it's going to be hard for most people who knew him very well. I know a lot of people are taking it hard, so. But, that's what happens when we get old, is we don't live forever.
Nope.
But he will live forever in the movies.
In people's hearts.
People's hearts, people's move, and the Star Wars movies. Because that's where the movies will last forever. So, but in good news, though, for Star Wars, is... John Williams, people thought he was going to be done with Star Wars music, score and stuff, after Episode 7. Well, he confirmed this week that he will be returning for the 8th time to the Star Wars franchise for Episode 8. Are you excited as I am, or as most people are?
I think it's great if he can do it.
I think he can. He's done quite a bit, and hopefully he's able to do Episode 9.
Mm-hmm. And 10.
Yeah.
This is 7, 8, 9. Oh, we're only doing them in threes. Whoops.
Exactly. Yeah. It's at 7, 8, 9. Hopefully we can see him do one more before he completely hopefully 2016 does not do this to us. I will not. I do not try dare thinking of what 2016 might do to us, which would suck, and that would be take John Williams away from us. After he takes and is able to do the score for that movie.
Mm-hmm.
So 2016, calm down on taking good celebrities. So, but yes, that's pretty much the Star Wars news for this week.
They have a few other things.
Well, not exactly confirmed, has it been?
Well, there's the Rogue One, and then there's the Han Solo trilogy.
Well, Rogue One, we did get a new trailer this last week, didn't we?
Yep.
Actually, we got it on last Thursday.
Mm-hmm.
After we recorded. So, what did you think of that trailer?
It's an expansion of what they were trying to do. I don't know if it has the new ideas that they wanted to implement in the reshoots, but it's exciting to see. It's going to be a different movie and not one that really... It's a Star Wars movie, but it's a different kind of Star Wars movie.
Right. I'm actually wondering, is there going to be any Jedi in this?
Well, there's Darth Vader at the end. That's a spoiler in the trailer, but...
Well, we already knew that was going to happen because everybody knew
they
that...
They said no other. No other will be there. So...
Well, they might say that, but we've known them to... throw loopholes into the mix?
Sometimes. I don't really think that they would have a mainline Jedi there. They might have some type of Force user that needs development, and we just don't know.
Right. We'll have to wait and see.
Mm-hmm.
I mean.
So. And they have more pictures of director Krennic. So we started a new Krennic performance page where we're going to pretend like we're acting like director Krennic because it's easy to do bad guys.
Right.
They're kind of fun.
You're more for doing the bad guys.
Yeah, the bad guys are kind of fun to play.
So, but yes,
and but it still doesn't say, you know, why he's bad in terms of how bad is he, and he's not badass like Thrawn is badass. This guy
he's
is
not
like,
a baddie bad.
He's bad, but he's not. He's just a, you know. He's like an idiot badass.
Right.
Idiot bad guy.
Right.
I can't use foul language to do say it any better than that.
Right.
He's a sycophant. He's a sycophant. And
so.
You can look that up. It's SYNCOPHANT.
Right.
So.
But,
yeah,
yes,
he's
that's,
like that.
And that's the good thing about Star Wars. I thought it was a good trailer. And I look forward to seeing what they do with this movie. But, in other news, Halloween is coming up, Gina.
What? We're starting now? It's not even my birthday yet.
Well, Halloween stuff's already being put out.
Oh, I don't go in there.
Well,
sorry.
I went to Walmart the other day, and I seen... some of the Halloween stuff being put out already. It's like...
They starting early?
Yeah, they're starting early.
Mm-hmm.
So, but in the honor of the Halloween season, did you know that they're remaking the a movie of the It? You remember the Stephen King movie It, right?
I remember it vaguely. I don't recall watching it all the way through because I got too scared or something.
Well, it's what caused people to not like clowns after that. Well, yeah. They're actually doing apparently they're doing a classic upcoming movie. Let's see. They're actually going to take...
Well, they're doing a lot of remakes, too, because they're doing one for Exorcist. And I'm like, whoa.
Yeah, but Exorcist...
So the girl's head is going to turn around 360 degrees?
Well, Exorcist actually didn't give people the nightmares of clowns.
No.
Where, basically, Stephen King, great author, don't get me wrong, he's done a lot of good books out there, but for them to remake this movie after it's already taken and with the way it was, already a horror flick as it is, mm-hmm. to where people won't even really watch it after the first time,
mm-hmm.
is bad. How much more horror can you get than mm-hmm. than the new, even the Pennywise, the new one is actually just as dark, if not probably, should I say, crazier?
I'm not going to watch it.
I'm not going to either. I'm sitting here like, I haven't even seen the first one.
I'll let the kids go do that, but I ain't going to watch it. I got better things to do.
Well, basically what it says here is the costume for the clown, Pennyworth,
mm-hmm.
is...
Pennywise,
yeah. Is that pleading... It's got kind of a pleading like the Elizabethan's era clothing.
Mm-hmm.
It's got kind of a more sheer look and kind of a... like a Joker kind of look. Not really Joker, but... like the old, should I say, classic medieval look,
mm-hmm.
where it's got fluff ruffles and stuff like that.
Okay.
So, it's got a picture on it and stuff of it, so it's like, I'm sitting here like, still don't know why they're remaking it.
Some doubt likes it and got the money for it.
Possibly. It's possible what it is. So, but yes. But then also is people who have seen Suicide Squad. Well, on the DVD when they pull out Suicide Squad, is they apparently are going to bring out Slipknot's deleted scene footage.
Mm-hmm.
So, but yes. Let's see here. What's for gaming? No. If it happened for Xbox 360, I wish they'd taken make this game for Xbox 360 again, is they're actually making a Mafia 3. Which basically, if you don't know what Mafia 3 is, Gina, and the listeners out there, I actually have played it, Mafia 2, and it's kind of takes place in the old school 50s and 60s type gangster era, kind of like Grand Theft Auto for the 60s.
Mm-hmm.
That was a fun game, too. Well, they're making a Mafia 3. So.
Wow.
Which I'm looking forward to. And let's see here. I guess Suicide Squad's Harley Quinn, for those who play Injustice 2, Injustice here, the Suicide Squad's Harley Quinn and Deadshot join Injustice 2. So, we're looking at another video game of Injustice. Let's see here. What else we got? Not too much else that really could really be too much.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we got PS4 updates. They brought out a new Turtle Beach lineup for mic for microphone and headphones and stuff. So for all of you who like the high quality of the Turtle Beach stuff, you've seen people with that Turtle Beach, right, Gina? No? It's actually one of the most popular headphones and gaming system headphones out there. More advanced. Mm-hmm. So. But I guess we're getting a Batman virtual Arkham virtual reality.
Mm-hmm.
Have you heard us? They're doing a Batman virtual reality game. Basically, Warner Brothers demoed the Batman Arkham virtual reality during San Diego Comic-Con back in July. So I'm surprised I didn't hear about this.
Wow.
And basically, the game is developed by Rocksteady Studios and will be exclusive to the PlayStation 4.
Mm-hmm.
So for all you PlayStation 4 players who like Arkham and stuff, well, they are going to have, the game itself is going to be part of the PlayStation Virtual Reality, VR.
Mm-hmm.
And basically, you get to actually wear the cowl.
Mm-hmm.
You actually get to play as Batman, and you get to see what he sees.
Hmm.
Interesting, huh?
Yeah, very interesting.
You and I grew up kind of close in the same age range. You remember mm-hmm. the virtual reality helmets.
Yeah, those things were huge.
Exactly. And we never thought they'd get back to virtual reality stuff.
Yeah, I thought that would...
Exactly. Oh, but yes. When I just read this, I was surprised. It's like, how much more can they throw out at us? Games.
I mm-hmm. mean,
so, but you know how they actually have an Assassin's Creed movie coming out, right? Based off the game.
Yeah.
They are actually going to be featuring characters from the games.
Yeah.
So, basically, we're looking at the Assassin's Creed movie is actually going to be taking and in the same universe as the game, but with different story and characters.
Mm-hmm.
But they're actually going to feature some of the characters from the games. So, that's kind of interesting.
Mm-hmm.
So, as far as this week's trivia question, we already went over it. Who would battle between Darth Vader and Darkseid? Put your questions, if you're listening to this through the Mixler, just type in your answer and we'll put it down. And next week, we will go over the actual answer, or what some of the questions, answers to the question.
Mm-hmm.
We don't know who would win. We're just assuming. I'm going to go with Darkseid because of his Omega Beam. That's the only thing that would save Darkseid. Gina, who do you pick?
I don't like any of it.
Oh, you don't pick any of it?
I pick Grand Admiral Thrawn. There.
Of course, she's going to go off into the Grand Admiral Thrawn. She's going to go she's going to start getting Thrawn in on here.
Yeah.
So, alrighty. Well, I think that pretty much summed it up for this week's episode. And stay tuned in the next month here. Oh, I just got some latest news. The latest posts on Nerd Reactor is, you know how Adam West and Burt Ward played the original Batman and Robin in the TV series?
Mm-hmm.
They are coming back in a new Batman animated series.
Really?
Yes.
Wow. But as who?
Batman and Robin.
All right, cool. Old up.
Yes. Entertainment is reporting that Adam West, Burt Ward, and Julie Newmar will be in an animated tale, rightly called Batman Return of the Crusaders.
Gonna be just as campy?
I'll have to watch the trailer and get it to... You'll have to watch the trailer here, because I'll take it... But yes, it's going to be actually really interesting. My question is, are they going to take and bring, for the Joker, are they going to have Mark Hamill?
That'd be better.
I think that would be about the most obvious choice. So, we'll have to wait and see. So, and that was the latest news that I just found out, so. And if you're listening to this through the channel 1138, listen, and if you're listening to YouTube, the links to Genius Swag 77 stuff is going to be down at in the description, along with the Geek Talk stuff. And give us a like on YouTube, give us a and subscribe. We'll bring out a new video every week. So until next week, on behalf of Dr. G and I, keep feet on the ground and keep aim for those stars. Have a good one.